Welcome to the Pajama Party Show. I'm your host, Michael Uhila. And I would like the ladies to introduce themselves, starting with you.
I'm Justine Molina.
I'm Lindy Quinn.
Hi, I'm Conea Jones.
I'm Shayla Faye.
And I'm Loretta.
Yes, we got a lovely show for you tonight. First of all, we got some discussion topics. Catch my breath. And what we're going to do is I have some black and white photography that I did some research on, and I wanted to showcase it to people out there in TV land. And so our first topic is women. Obviously, you're here. So what is going on through your mind? You're very mysterious. I don't know nothing. Who wants to jump in?
Okay,
go ahead.
What makes you think us women are mysterious? We're the normal ones, and I figure that sometimes you guys are a little
strange,
and
men are quite mysterious.
I think we're just complex.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, complex, diverse.
You guys keep your emotions.
That's a nice
word.
We're the normal ones.
What should men do? Well, what should they do when they're around you? Should talk.
Be honest.
Yes.
Okay, wait. One at a time. This is getting really complicated. You're confusing me. This is like a jigsaw puzzle. Starting off with you.
Me? I believe that they should be honest and funny.
Okay.
I think funny is always good.
Okay.
In most situations.
All right.
Funny and honest.
And you?
Respectful, charming, loving, caring. And
you're talking about men, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Of course.
I thought you were talking about like a teddy bear.
No, I know. Okay. Just express your feelings out loud.
Okay. Honest, funny, and then you got express your feelings out loud. Talk more, right?
Oh, yeah. Be respectful.
Respectful.
The whole teddy bear thing.
A teddy bear.
Teddy bear.
There's a summarize. All right. How about you?
I think men need to be more considerate and thoughtful.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You?
I think men should just, I don't know. I agree with all the rest of the ladies. To be more considerate, thoughtful, understanding. They have to understand us. We are complex. However, if you just listen more with an open mind, you will understand us.
Listen more. Okay. And you?
I think it's important to just say what you mean and mean what you say. For example, don't ask us how we're feeling, how was our day, if you're just going to be thinking about your video game.
That's so true.
Good point. Very good point.
So, you have some things that you're concerned about. Okay, so what can you do to help men kind of get out of that stuffiness or be more honest or funny? Because a lot of guys try to be something else but not be themselves.
Well, you can't necessarily change them. You just have to find that mature man.
Okay.
Maturity. So I believe maturity does play a huge role.
So he's got to be older?
I am dating an older man.
It's nothing wrong with dating older men.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay, no.
Younger guys can be mature too.
Yeah, I agree.
You just have to find the right person.
Well, I'm 18, right. So I'm living in that era. I can say. Not that much.
For the older.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I learned that lesson now too.
I just wanted to tell the people out there in TV land, if you just tuned in and you're wondering what this is all about, this is the Pajama Party. We've got some lovely ladies here, some of the models and actresses, and they're giving some educational tips for you people out there. If you don't know, you might know after this. I don't even know right now. But welcome to the show. I'm Michael Uhila. Once again, say your names.
Justine.
Lindy.
Conea.
Shay.
Loretta.
Okay. And we were talking about what men can do better or how we So...
What should be vice versa?
Vice versa? What, you want me to speak for men?
Yeah, well, sure. Men and women should both be the same. They should both be respectful, considerate, acknowledgeable.
Respect begets respect. Like, disrespect begets, well, anyway. You gotta be respectful, right?
Yeah.
You can't be, like, dressed like a hooker and think a guy's gonna treat you like a nun.
The relationship has to be symbiotic.
That's a mixed signal, complex. Mm. We're not sure, like, what does she want? Guys are like, I'm confused.
Well, maybe they dress like that because it gets your attention.
So you want attention?
Of course we want attention. If we don't want attention, if we don't get attention from our man, then who else can we get it from?
Your girl.
But that's the mirror similarity. That like with men and women, men want attention from women too. Hence the expensive clothes, the expensive cars.
Cars.
You know, all the nice, you know, sunglasses, TV watches, shows, and all of that. So I think that's something that we have in common, men and women. We want to, you know, impress the opposite.
We just display it in a different way.
You just display it.
We're more, as women, we're more expressive in emotions. Men are more masculine. I mean, that's the common knowledge of it.
Okay, well, fair enough. We got a roll-in queued. Okay, we're here. Roll-in queued. And I did some research on black and white photography, and it's up to you viewers to let us know if it sucks or it's no good or whatever. I'm a fan of black and white photography, so we're going to... You ladies want to check this out?
Sure.
Yeah.
All right. So Roland is ready. Go ahead and take it away. So I did this research on black and white.
I love black.
Pajama Party Show. What you just saw was black and white photography, the art of black and white photography, or what they call in technical terms, monochrome. Opinions?
I love black and white photography. I do a lot of artistic nudes and implied work and even fashion. And actually, my partner is a photographer, so we've been experimenting with double exposure and contrast. And my most recent shoot that I'll be having will be representing Greek and Roman sculptures within black and white to totally capture the bodyscapes. It's so exciting, it's so artistic, and it's so subtle but so expressive. I love black and white photography.
Okay, so we got a pro person that we really like. Okay, and you, Lindy?
I like black and white photos too. It's vintage, like, almost. I just take photos for fun, just, So I really don't.
I think black and white photos are very intense, like especially when you look at the fashion aspect of it. Like it's just really intense and brings out emotions better than like some color photos. Just my opinion.
Very true.
Okay. Well, we're gonna get into that again later. And Shay, I love black and white photography.
I love black and white photography. I've taken several pictures with different photographers in black and white, and it does have the vintage effect to it, and it has so much emotion. It says so much in black and white than it does in color to me. Okay. The grays, the shadowing, and like she contrast, said, the sculpture, silhouettes. The contrast, okay. Silhouettes. It's amazing. It's beautiful.
Okay.
Love it.
And you, Loretta?
Yeah, I agree. I do like black and white photos a lot. It has a timeless feel to it. It always works. And, you know, with black and white, I find that a lot of photographers definitely are going back to black and white. And even, you know, just snapshots that I take with my friends, sometimes we go on Photoshop and convert our colored photos to black and white just to add that kind of timeless abstract look to it.
Okay. Yeah. So it sounds like we have some people that are for black and white photography. I would like to get into two different type of black and white photographies. We have film and we have digital. Digital, the pro of digital is that you can do things faster. You can shoot 6,000 exposures. Don't even have to do anything. Just make sure you have battery. With film, you have to change the film. You have to process the film, develop the film. I've been in dark rooms where you had to sit there for hours and, you know, develop. So that's some of the things that, so some people are more into this. So describe a little bit about digital and film, or have you shot in any of those mediums?
Film is incredible. I mean, the grains in photos that are produced by film, it's like she had mentioned, it's very timeless, it's very classic. It's definitely takes much more work to develop the photos. But both, I feel, are adequate enough, but film definitely will always be a classic in photography.
Agreed.
I haven't had much experience with it, but so far, I don't have that much experience.
Okay. All right. Come on, film or digital?
I would say either or. I mean, I enjoy photography in general,
but they're,
so
they're both
I don't
good
have
for
a
different
choice.
Reasons. They're not, yeah. One is not better than the other a lot of times.
Mm-hmm.
But like for instance, if you're driving across Australia, are you gonna be lugging around 78, you know, rolls of film?
Right.
You might want some, you know, digital.
That's true. It's a technical difficulty.
Right. So, and then it's like, yeah. Like, damn, I want to make sure my car is in the right temperature and so
right.
That the film doesn't melt and all this other. So
right.
There's things to consider, details that might cause your film to be messed up.
The weather.
Yeah.
Yeah, the weather.
True. Exposure.
Yeah.
I remember being younger and, you know, I was watching a movie that they had the film and they were taking it out, putting it in the water in a dark room. And I'm like, oh, that would be really nice for me to do. So I took my grandmother's camera. I took the film off the camera. And here I am in the bathroom in the sink with her film for about 10 minutes. And I'm like, it's not working. Yeah. But digital all the way for me. I'm sorry. I don't have the patience. Digital.
I mean, I like both, but I think I definitely appreciate film more. It's like Christmas, you know? You don't get to take a picture and then look back at it, and if you don't like it, you can delete it and then do it again. But with film, it is what it is. You get what, you know, you just have to be extra careful with how you, I guess, take the photos, and then you don't know what it looks like until it's ready to be developed. So it definitely feels like, you know, a gift when it's you see it for the first
all
time.
All in the art of capture.
Yeah.
I just want to say that also that those photos were protected by the Disclaimer Act because we are critiquing it, so to speak, and they can say it sucks or it's all good or it's no good. So just want to say that. You'll see that at the end of the show. Okay, back to the photography. Any of you have cameras? And if you do, like, you don't have to come out.
I've been practicing with my partner with Nikon.
Okay.
He's been teaching me about exposure and I can't think of the terms right now, but I practiced in New Orleans.
Apertures.
Yeah. Sorry.
I got my cliff notes right here.
Oh. We practiced in New Orleans and we did nude shoots in public,
okay.
Black and white, and it was exhilarating.
All right.
Scared a few tourists.
Okay. We also have since we're still staying in the vein of black and white photography.
Okay.
This next photo. This set of slides is dedicated to the most mysterious people on this planet, women. This is women around the world, all around the world, different kind of women, different sizes, shapes, colors. bra sizes, all of that different. go ahead and write. Here we go. All right, Black and White Photography, dedicated to the most mysterious creatures on this planet, women. That's just my opinion.
I was quick with that.
We don't know. Men don't know. Well, I don't know. Anyway, so Black and White Photography, the subject was women in that. Now, as you saw, there was different sizes, shapes, colors, international, very unique. You know, it was like different hairstyle. It was all kinds of stuff. So your thoughts?
I'm at a loss of words.
Well, I think that it's beautiful. It shows women from all over the world. We are beautiful no matter what color we are, what culture we may be, what religious belief. We're women. We all experience the same thing. And that's what that showed. You know, we can be different. We can be bold. We can be strong. All in photography. It showed it.
Right. You?
Well, I thought it was just beautiful to look at. I enjoyed it.
Okay.
I liked all of it. All the different shapes and sizes. Yeah. Everything.
Sizes.
Makeup.
Well, it also,
styles.
The other thing about it is, you know, whenever you do headshots, a lot of times, how do you say headshots? Can you explain that in layman's terms to people that don't know?
Headshots, I mean, like everyone knows.
Close up, like a from your head to your neck. Probably.
It's
your
also classical and environmental neck. Portraits.
Right. So just the regular, like headshots.
Just headshots. People, okay. I think everyone knows what a headshot is.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, I don't want to assume
unless
anything.
Unless they,
yeah.
You know, unless
almost
it's
like a mugshot.
I thought you didn't want to talk that much. What happened? Okay, so you have the headshots. Okay, so in that, you saw there was different angles.
Mm-hmm.
There were different lighting. as you can see, the lighting in here took a long time. And if this was a black and white photo shoot, you know, they'd have to make sure that the tone was right for each skin color, shape.
Need a couple soft boxes.
Soft boxes. So it's just one of those things that understanding the technical part of black and white photography. Mm-hmm. Also, just I mean, I have respect for color. There's nothing wrong with that. So being able to recognize that, and you're models. So mm-hmm. What do you do to make it look good, or is it the camera guy
it's
doing
the
all the work?
It's the light. You have to go with.
They're
the
like,
light.
We make crap look like peanut butter with this photography. Look at this. No,
just that's like, true though. No, it, the no, photographer plays a lot, but the model, it they have to play on the light.
Okay.
All the lighting. It's your stage.
Okay.
So when you have the light, you have to play with the light and the shadows and make it work.
Photo shoots. Talk a little bit about what happens on a photo shoot. Just like, I'll give you an example. Like, for instance, I'll give you an example. I'll call you up. Say, Loretta, we got a photo shoot.
then what's the rest of the, what, fill in the blanks, what happens?
Well, first I'd have to know what the nature of the photo shoot is. So then based on that, I would put together a wardrobe, what to wear. Is it appropriate to have jewelry, nail polish, and how I'm going to do my makeup? Is my hair going to be straight or curled? So it really just depends on, you have to have, I guess, you know, clear communication. What is the nature of the shoot and location also? You don't want to have like some flowy mini skirt at a windy beach or something like that. Unless that's what you're going for.
Marilyn Monroe. Okay.
Talk a little bit about, photographer calls you up and he says, okay, we have a photo shoot at 8 o'clock. Fill in the blanks of what has happened in your experience.
Well, for me, I'd have to know if there's a makeup artist and a hairstylist, and is there wardrobe there? And if not, then I'd have to gather all the things necessary, find out what's the concept, what is the point of the photo shoot, you know, and just do everything geared towards that so we can have a nice outcome.
Okay.
Yeah.
And Justine.
Me.
I was here.
Forgot my name.
No. I said it though.
So just, you're halfway. No.
We're having fun. Okay, it's a pajama party. Sometimes people forget people's names. No, go ahead.
Well, I would of course need to know the concept of the photo shoot and befriend the photographer, because chemistry is what always counts. A lot of the photography that I do relates to artistic, in an artistic context.
What does that mean? Just some like paint on the wall, or like,
well,
some duct tape put together. I mean, what, yeah. Art is like a really broad word. It's
very
vague a lot of times.
Very favorite quote of mine is, art disturbs the comfortable and comforts the disturbed. So when I do my photo shoots, you know, you have the makeup artist, the hair, whatever, but you know, you can be a pretty girl, but can that pretty girl really express anger, fear, love, lust? That's what makes a model a model.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Well, indeed.
Okay. So, fill in the blanks. When a photographer calls you up, and we're like, so how much is this going to cost?
Like, how much are you getting
paid? I'm a volunteer model. You know what I'm saying? I'm getting a picture for the 7-Eleven.
Yeah. No, actually, I go through a broad amount of things. Like, it's a relationship. Most of the time, when a photographer calls me up, he already knows me as a model. He knows what I'm about. He knows what I'm good, like what situation I'll be good under. I need to know a lot of things. I need to know: A, is there a makeup artist? Or do I have to bring my own makeup? Okay. What is the theme of the photo shoot? Because I know I deal with a lot of photographers that have themes, whether it's lifestyle or it's an actual themed photography. So I have to be aware of what I'm getting into. And once I'm aware, I'm fully prepared.
Okay. Well, I would just like to thank all you lovely ladies for being here in the studio at the Pajama Party, Michael Uhila Presents. I would like to thank the crew, Don Serlin, Maya Ram, Jay Shree, Karen Adams, Bill, Steve, and the director, Daniel, and also Trish Gray. See, I remember, I got everybody. And Felino, I love you. Thank you for helping out.
Felino.
Philip.